The most costly thing that can happen is that you get the right connections but the wrong answers, and you're not prepared because you're going to lose people, not going to look professionals. It would have been possible maybe 5-10 years ago when the competition was low. Today you can't afford to do that anymore. You need to be absolutely ready, have the right answers, absolutely the perfect financials and answer to everything. That's the way it is, because if you are not, someone else will be. The key documents you need, one is a good teaser. We usually use 250 words, very punchy. For people, actually we realize people don't even read attachment anymore. They need to be teased, say, yes, please send me your deck, that sounds interesting. The second thing is then the deck, obviously, 15 slides, that's really the main thing in the UK. In the US it's a bit less. And it needs to tell a story. Each slide needs to tell a story, and the whole deck is a story as well. The financials as well are really important. We like 5 years, because that's the horizon of time that an investor would be looking at. And that also need to tell a story. And often we see that actually the story that is told in the financials is not the same as the story in the deck. So one of the first things when we do investment readiness is to make sure that all the stories fit together. You don't have a teaser saying something, the deck saying something else, and the financial something else. And once you got your financials right and your story right in the financials, then you find it easy to tell the story, because precisely what investors understand is financials. So anything you tell them in relationship to financials is going to be relevant. A good investor deck is a deck that tells a story that not only makes the USP clear, you understand how unique it is, and if it's not, it's doing something else that others might not do. So for example, often we say it's good to have the problems have to be well understood. They also need to, those decks, to understand what the existing solutions, what they do and what they don't do. And what they don't do is what you are doing. And that's really important to define your USP. Obviously, that's also important to show your traction. And your traction, what is it? Well, if you got sales, that speaks for itself, a profit even better. But we know that not everybody can have sales and profit at early stage. So the other thing is your team. How great your team is. What have they done before? They done an exit? Are they serial entrepreneurs? Anything that would make an investor in confidence. The team, the partnership as well, very important. Who are the partners? Who has already signed up? Is there any document, letter of interest you got? That's traction that shows, yes, we are. This is not only you believing in this project. Could also be employees who decided to take shares in your company or be paid for sweat equity. All of that is a sign for an investor you got traction.